The views and opinions expressed in the following program are those of the hosts and guests, and not necessarily those of the staff or management of Worldwide Digital Broadcasting Corporation.
Rise!
Get yourselves together!
Rise!
Stand up and live your life!
Rise!
Get yourselves together!
Rise!
Hands up high!
Women in the United States and in Western Europe are the freest and most liberated in human history. In many ways, they are not merely doing as well as men, they are doing better. Women's emancipation is one of the glories of Western civilization and one of the great chapters in the history of freedom. So why then are those in the women's movement, such as the leaders and members of activist groups like the National Organization for Women, the professors in women's studies departments at our colleges, and many women in the media, why are they still so dissatisfied? These feminists hardly acknowledge women's progress. Yes, they concede that some advances have been made, but the fact that most women reject their activist brand of feminism and think of themselves as free is, for this crowd, proof of just how entrenched patriarchy and inequality truly are. Women are so oppressed, they don't even know it. Year after year, these activists make claims about women in violence, women in depression, women in eating disorders, women in workplace injustice, to support their views. Over the years, I have looked carefully at many of these claims. And what I have found is that much of the supporting evidence, mostly victim statistics, is misleading and often flat out wrong. Consider the issue of the so-called gender wage gap. How many times have you heard that for the same work, women receive 77 cents for every dollar a man earns? This charge is constantly repeated by feminist activists and their supporters. Yet it is so deeply misleading as to border on outright falsehood. 23-cent gender pay gap is simply the difference between the average earnings of all men and women working full-time. It does not take account for differences in occupations, positions, education, job tenure, or hours worked per week. Now, wage gap activists in groups like the American Association of University Women or the National Women's Law Center, they say, no, even when you control for these factors, women still earn less. Well, it always turns out that they have omitted one or two crucial data points. Take the case of doctors. On the surface, it looks like female physicians are clearly victims of wage discrimination. They appear to earn less for the same work. But dig a little deeper beneath the surface, and you find that women are far more likely than men to enter lower-paying specialties like pediatrics or family medicine than higher-paying cardiology or anesthesiology. They are also more likely to work part-time. And even women who work full-time put in about 7% fewer hours than men. Women physicians are also far more likely to take long leaves of absence, usually to start a family. Now, there are exceptions, but most workplace pay gaps narrow to the point of vanishing when one accounts for all of these relevant factors. Now, how do the women's advocacy groups react to this? They insist that women's choices are not truly free. Women who decide, say, to stay home with children or to work fewer hours or to become pediatricians rather than heart surgeons are held back by invisible barriers or internalized oppression. According to the National Organization for Women, powerful sexist stereotypes steer women and men toward different educational training and career paths and family roles. But is it really social conditioning that explains women's vocational preferences and their special attachment to children? Perhaps in the pursuit of happiness, men and women take somewhat different paths. And isn't it more than a little patronizing to suggest that most American women are not free, they're not self-determining human beings? And here is common sense proof that the male-female wage gap is untrue. If it were really true that an employer could get away with paying Jill less than Jack for the exact same work, wouldn't most employers fire as many of their male employees as possible and replace them with females and enjoy a huge market advantage? As a regular campus lecturer, I routinely encounter students who have fully accepted the feminist propaganda. American college women are arguably the most fortunate, liberated beings on the planet, yet in their feminist theory classes, they're likely to learn that they are put upon and tyrannized by men. And the more elite the school, the more advanced the degree, the more likely they are to take such feminist propaganda seriously. But this doesn't have to continue. The time has come for young women to take back feminism, reform it, correct its excesses, repudiate the victim propaganda, get rid of the women are from Venus, men are from hell storylines, and begin the arduous task of correcting almost three decades of feminist misinformation. And women who are plagued by workplace injustice or sexual violence will be best helped by truth and solid research, not by hysteria and hype. And as a final piece of personal advice for young women, appreciate and make good use of the unprecedented freedom that you have. I'm Christina Hoff Summers of the American Enterprise Institute for Prager University.
And I'm Heidi Mancini.
Any announcements? Oh, well, that's an announcement.
And this is my daughter, Ava.
Hi.
So she's our guest today on the Rise Above Show. We just want to thank Jay Jung from City Athletic Club for sponsoring the Rise Above Show. We're also, if you're looking to help us advertise for your business, your product, or service, write to me, either message me through Facebook or on the Rise Above Show, and we can get together and talk about some sponsorship. I can help you advertise your service, business, or product, and you can also help Joe and I spread out the news of our show. The other thing, you can reach us at josephperoni.com, WWDBTV, which is where we're broadcasting out of right now, and you can also reach us on Facebook. Joe Peroni has his personal Facebook page. I have mine, Heidi Mancini. And we also have the From Rise Above show page. So there's a lot of ways that you can get a hold of Joe and I. Our emails are, Joe's email is bdillonesque, which I don't know if I should spell all that. Actually, you know what? Just get
like
a hold
Bob
of me.
Bob Dylan.
Just get a hold of me because I do all the social media and I do all the sponsorship for our show. So my email is camilio1@icloud.com. It's C-A-M-I-L-L-I-O, the number one, at iCloud. So if you message me on either Facebook or on my email, I will be sure to get back to you. And also, if you ever have any ideas for our show, subjects that you want us to talk about, we're always open for new ideas, new guests. If you have a friend or something that somebody in the community that you want us to talk to, we're open for all that. So give us a holler.
Perfect. Now, I'm not going to deny you the pleasure of announcing our guest today.
This is my daughter, Ava Marie. So she's here today. We're going to talk about what she wanted to talk about was anti-sexism. So it's a really interesting subject, and I want to just say something really quickly before we get started. I had this happen to me this morning, and I think what women were saying a few months ago, we're not doing anything political right now, is they just were afraid that they don't want to lose what they have, okay? But we talk about what is feminism and what is anti-sexism, and basically, it's equality. I said to one of my friends the other day at the salon, I said, what don't you have? Mm-hmm. What do we feel we need to fight for that we don't have? And she said, nothing. And I feel the same way. I feel like I can work any job I can work at. I can make as much money as I want. I have the freedom to dress the way I want. I can say what I want. I mean, sometimes there's consequences to that. But, you know, in the most part, women are pretty free to express themselves and do what we want when we want. So my question is, and I had this happen this morning, there's a thing, it's a respect level, and I'm not sure now where that plays into all the anti-sex, anti-feminism, or feminism. I walk my dogs every morning, and I always run into these gentlemen on my path, and there's a couple of them, and they have their dogs, and almost every day I move out of the way. You know, so I said, today, let's see what today, I'm going to see if we're going to play chicken this morning. I'm going to see who's going to move first, just to see. Maybe I'm, you know, so I'm walking my dogs, and I have two choices. I can either walk down the hill, which is a bunch of stone, which is pretty tricky, but we maneuver it, me and my two dogs, or I can go stand up on the hill, but it's an incline, and if the dogs get excited, they start to run down the hill, and of course, I've almost wiped out before trying to hold both of my dogs. So I said, that would not be the better choice, so I meandered down the hill, and I went on my way. But and there was a part of me that got irritated because I thought, you know, what happened to, I'm a woman, he's a man, I have two dogs, he has one, why couldn't he move out of my way for once, you know? So I didn't say anything. I went on my merry way, and I said, just let it go, because it's not worth. So I said this to Joe this morning. I said, but where does it come down to, okay, we have equality now as women, so I don't have a problem opening a door for a man, and I don't think there's men that have a problem opening a door for a man, but I guess at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter anymore. What the old way of thinking about chivalry, right, or, you know, my idea of respect is not, when you start talking about equality, that's all wiped off the table. There's no such thing now as a man should open the door. It's nice, but it's not expected. And you said to me, I have entitlements. And I would say to you, I don't feel entitled, but I feel that, you know, I will open a door for a man. They should open a door for me. And I guess maybe I am a little bit entitled, but I'm kind of old school in a respect kind of a way.
I think it's an age thing.
And I just had to laugh at these guys because, you know, they're younger than me, and there's a lot of factors that fall into that. And then I say to myself, well, you know, they're younger, they're gentlemen. They're not gentlemen, actually. And so I said, but let it go. You know, there's no point in rehashing that. And it's funny that we're talking about that today, because I'm like, well, equality equals what?
I don't know. It's a good question.
It means, ladies, it's off the table now. You know, the guy doesn't have to open the car door for you anymore. He doesn't have to do a lot of things that they used to. Before, they used to throw a, if there was water, I mean, that cracks me up. That was way back in the day. They would throw something on the ground, a coat, so the lady could walk across the ground and not get her shoes wet.
That's, you know, true.
I mean, guys used to do some amazing
stuff. I gotta say something though. What else doesn't make a woman's feet get wet? Shoes.
True.
So she can walk out of her own freaking thing and you have shoes on. So why would you mess up a coat? That's the whole thing.
I know, but the point I'm getting at is that it was back in the day before all this feminist movement, that was part of being a man. So now that we're all equal, my thing is I honestly don't, I'm an anti-feminist because I don't believe in a lot of the stuff that, because I think it's a lot of male bashing and it's a way of, you know, trying to emasculate the men and put them down. So that's how I view feminism. Mm-hmm. So I'm not a part of that. Although I work, I have a career, I like to make my own money, I make my own decisions most of the time. I don't want those rights taken from me by the government or the man that I'm with or any other, or a woman. Let's just say nobody.
Right.
Those are rights that I have as being a human being. So
that's true.
You know.
But I think it's an age thing, though, right? Like, at my age, it's just manners. It's gentlemanly to do certain things, like hold a door. If it was me, I would have moved out of the way for you. You know, these types of things. But in our world right now, part of being equal means that you cannot expect other people to do things that you can just as easily do for yourself. So sure, there's the feminism part, and I would say up until not that long ago, I would consider myself a feminist, right? Even though I'm a man. I'm liberal, I'm a Democrat. Let's start it from like 1920. Women deserve the right to vote, obviously. I'm also, I would be pro-choice. So on women's issues, I'm all there. But when it comes to the point of women all of a sudden buying into this learned helplessness, this whole victim mentality thing, I'm not really sure where they're going. And just to make it a little bit political, because that's where my brain works, as a liberal Democrat, these women who say that they're feminist, they're ruining it for the political party, because this victim mentality is destroying normal people who look at life and go, hold it, you don't want equal rights, you want special rights.
But can I say something that I've noticed, and then Ava, we're going to get her involved in this, because she's from a younger generation. What I noticed with this whole, when you said, you know, the Democratic with the women, we talked about this too. When a woman makes a lot of money and she has a position of power, she has the same entitlements that men have. Mm-hmm. Men, over the course of time, the more money they make, the higher they are in stature, it doesn't matter what it is, they have entitlements. They feel like, because I'm this, I do this. You owe me that. I don't have any accountability because I make this much money, or I have this high position in a corporation, so I'll do what I say. You know, they pretty much do what they say. Women are the same way. The more money a woman makes, the more entitled she becomes, and the more demanding she could become. And I think when she's up in that corporate setting with men, she tends to get a feminist viewpoint. The women that are on the other end of that I find that do this whole feminist victimization thing are women that choose to basically either depend on the man 100%, and there's nothing wrong with that, but you can't play both sides of it. You know, you can't say, well, I don't like men, but they're usually women that can't pay their own bills. They need a man in their life, so then they do the whole, you know, feminist thing. Men are this, men are that. So I find that it's either the higher up that you are, or the lower that you, not the lower, I don't want to say the lower, that's not the right word to use. I mean, I could say specific people that I've seen this happen, that it comes from, but then that's not right either, because that's my projection.
Right.
A lot of, you know, the women that I've come into that play the whole victim card are usually women that use men for their money, and it's either girls that are in the entertainment business, it's women that latch on to men with money. They're the ones that sometimes play that whole victim. They mm-hmm. want to play both sides of it. I don't like you as a man, but I'm going to take your money. I think you're a piece of shit every other day of the week, but please pay my bills and, you know, whatever. So right, that's been my thing on it. And women are getting, I'm not saying it's wrong, I'm not saying it's right, but I think the more secure a woman feels monetarily, the more entitled she feels. And men have done that forever. I mean, men have had that right through every generation. And women now are starting to adopt that same mindset. And while they're doing that, it's taking away from the anti-feminist women that say, I want to work and I want to be able to provide for my family too, but I still want to be treated like a woman. I want a door held open for me. I want a guy to buy me flowers once in a while. I want him to treat me like I am a different sex than him.
Hmm. So Ava, so what do you think?
It
was your subject.
Yeah, I think the whole thing is pretty stupid, honestly. I think that I don't even know the whole door opening thing and all that. I mean, for me personally, yeah, like I remember, you know, being brought up into that too, where, you know, a guy should open a door for you and everything, but it really doesn't matter. It's a person is a person. So if a woman, like, opens a door for you, then a woman opens a door for you. If a man opens a door, then a man opens a door, really. I mean, it doesn't matter. It's, like, if it's just a person. Like, so that's what I see. Like, I know that there's different genitalia, so there's obviously different sexes, but in all actuality, I don't really see that. I just see, like, a person that's respectful in my book. Like, if someone opens the door for me, thank you. I don't really care if you're a guy, if you're a girl. If you open a door, thanks. If I have a freaking handful of boxes and you open a door, I'm gonna appreciate you. Like, I don't care, but I just think women are kind of whiny nowadays. Like, they want more than what they already have. We already have the basic human rights. What more do you want? I mean, honestly, like, I just think it's stupid. And then a lot of times women are, like, they want to complain and be like, they want to be like a victim and be like, oh, well, they make themselves not get up in life. You know, they can go to school. They can do things that they want to, just as anybody else can.
Yeah, they make it seem like the male is the oppressor. Well, yeah. I can't do anything. It's your fault. Oh, John is going to say something over there. Go ahead.
I was asking permission first.
You can.
Oh, go ahead.
So how many women do you know like that? The whiners, the people that want that special treatment.
A lot.
In your life, in your friends, how many do you know?
A lot.
Okay.
A lot.
And see, my experience is just the opposite. There are a few out there, and they make it look bad for everybody else. And they do tend to be younger because they figure they're going to take advantage of the situation.
Yeah.
But, I mean, the whole feminist movement is actually 100-something years old.
Right.
And we have made a lot of progress. There's still places to go, just like racism, sexism, everything else. But you get those individuals that are going to take advantage of the situation. You hit it on the head, Heidi. Hmm. It's like you just want a guy. We used to call them chip whores.
The girls that I honestly, the girls that I know that do that, every single one of them. I'm in the salon. I'm in the gym. I'm in access to all kinds of women from different you know levels of wherever they are in their life. And the ones that I listen to that play that victim card are the ones that usually are the ones that they're strippers. I even hate to say that word, and it's not a bad word. It's just that they're in a position of where they feel oppressed, but they put themselves there.
And that's
okay, they don't want to go to school. They
made.
Don't want to better themselves.
Right.
Then they latch onto these guys that you know have a lot of money or whatever they think they have. Because a lot of times they don't have what a lot of these women think they have, but they talk a big game, whatever. They latch onto that, and they're still unhappy, and they're still miserable, and they blame the man. Well, it's your fault that I can't do this. It's your fault that I don't make enough money. No, it's not. It's your fault because you're relying, you're being codependent on somebody to take care of you. So just say that. My thing is I don't think I've known a few women in my life that have honestly come right out and said it. If a guy does not make a certain amount of money, I don't want to be with him. I am not going to support a man. He's going to be my equal. If he can't at least do what I do and we're on the same playing field, I don't want to date a guy that's beneath me. There's nothing wrong with that because I'm sure there's men out there that are like that too. They'll make a discernment of who they would like to date or they don't want to date. So
it's all preference, honestly, and it's per person. The whole thing that I disagree with feminism is that they always want to clump everything into a whole. Mm. You can't.
But
everybody's
wait, you just
separate.
Did that.
Well, yeah.
You just did that. You just lumped feminism into, you know, I mean that's a general term that you can't really go there.
Yeah.
I mean, the ones that are vocal and the ones that you see, that's the ones that you're talking about.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, there's people like your mother that from my experiences in dealing with her and Joe, that she is a self-actualized woman who feels equal and does not feel like she has to be treated special. And it goes back to what you said. I open doors for people regardless of whether they're male or female. And it's not, I mean, I was brought up that way.
Yeah.
You walk on the outside of the sidewalk. You know, that's what you're supposed to do. The woman walks on the inside, you walk on the outside. But I don't do that. I do it to show respect. Or somebody's walking in the store behind me. I will stand there for a minute and hold the door while they come in, regardless. Young, old, male, female, you know, whatever color they are. That's just a sign of respect for another human being. And I think that's what you're talking about, what we are getting away from.
Mm-hmm.
Are these people out on the fringes? Because those are the ones that we hear about all the time. Those are the ones on Facebook, and those are the ones on TV and shit, bitching about all this and trying to use something that they have to gain an advantage.
Yeah.
That sucks.
Well, yeah, because I was going to say something, but I don't know if I can, but it's basically...
You can say anything you want.
It's basically when a woman's like... When people say out there, well, she has a pussy, so she's in control. They always say that because if you have a vagina, you control the world. And I think that's bull. I think it's bull crap. I think no one should control anything, but that's just my opinion. But they always want to go on statistics. They want to be like, a woman makes 70 cents to the dollar of every man. And I'm like, yeah, but you can't really clump that together because everybody has their own job. Every man makes their own hours, makes their own pay. That you can't really put that together. And I just think that that's like stupid. I think it's just another thing for these feminists to complain about, and I just think it's just dumb.
Other thing is there's more women out in the workforce now too, which you don't hear that okay, even if women are only making 70 cents on the dollar, there's still more women working and going to college now than men, but we don't talk about that there's still more women taking the jobs. We have the jobs that men would have because now we're equal. So I can do your job if I wanted to. You could do mine. So they don't talk about all the women that are out there taking jobs away from the male. And if they're not making a full dollar, we're still more employed out there, and there's more women in colleges today than men.
Hmm. And that's true. But getting back to the pay equality thing, what they're saying is that apples to apples, if you and I are doing the exact same job, we should be getting the same pay. Statistically, and when I say statistically, I use that term because that's what it is. 3 and 3 make 6. So statistically, if you have 2 pairs of 3s, you got 6.
Yeah.
And that's what it is. Statistically, women who are doing the same job are getting paid less as a general rule, not all the time, but as a general rule. And the people, the proponents of the equal pay is just, hey, we should all, if you're doing this job, you should get the same pay I get, yeah, whether you're a man or a woman, and that's it.
Well, because I know, like, where I work, like, I get more hours than the person that I work with. We get the same pay, but I work more hours. Right. So in all actuality, I do get more money.
No. But you are getting the same amount, dollar for dollar, hour for hour.
Yeah.
If you work more hours, that has nothing to do with your rate of pay.
Yeah.
Now, if you were making a dollar less than this other person, you would have to work more hours to make the same amount of money that they're making.
Yeah. But who controls that are the people that run these corporations and these CEOs that are sitting behind the desk. And that's where the regulation is not happening, and they get away with all that garbage. And most people don't realize that they're making a dollar less until they start talking. Because I've worked at jobs where they call you in the office, they go, this is your starting wage, but you don't have to discuss this with the other girls in the department because, right, you know, some have been here a long time, some are just starting, and we, you know, so they, I've worked, I've done it. So basically that is the person that's way up in the corporate CEO that's sitting there determining that, and though there's no regulations on that, so until there starts to be more of a regulation on, right, that, that's going to, it's basically, you're my favorite, so I'm going to pay you more money.
Right.
Or you're a woman, I'm going to pay, because that happens too. Sure. You're pretty, I'm going to pay you more money.
But, you know, okay, but as a liberal, this is one of the things that hurts me, actually, because I want to be for the cause, in a sense. But it's virtually...
Don't do that. I'm serious. Don't do that. That's what's fucking wrong with us, man. Fuck the cause.
Well, that's true.
This is what it needs to be. And I don't give a shit. And that's what's wrong with our political system is...
Yeah.
I'm sticking with my party. Fuck your party.
Well, that's my point. Is
sorry,
because
I feel strongly about that. So,
I'm glad
sorry,
you do.
Dude, I know this is your
Listen,
show.
We've actually... We've done two shows on this gender pay equality or inequality. Right. And when you really look at all the moving parts, it's a made-up thing, for the most part, that feminists use. Because if you look at a lot of jobs, right, you look at state jobs, they can't say you're a man, you're a woman, we'll pay you different. If you're starting off as a teacher, all of these jobs are equal, period, end of story. So there's nothing to complain about there. We all get paid equal for the same job. The problem is that they come upon these numbers, because you know that you can take stats and move them any way you want. One of the ways they do is they take a certain amount of men, and they cumulative, they look at how much money they have, and women cumulative look how much money they have and go, oh, it looks like the men made more. Mm-hmm. It doesn't work like that. If you're a teacher and you're a teacher, you have 3 years, you're at this college, it's all equal. Where it starts to move a little bit is the fact that men work more overtime. You know, women tend to put their family values ahead. So they take off from hours more. Or if you get someone in a job that's been working there, let's say a man's been working for 12 years, and a woman's there technically for 12 years, but she took off 4 years to have a kid, and then all this time before the kid goes to school, she's really working for 8 years. And when you figure it out like that, it is equal. And it depends also on what jobs you're working at.
Well, and it also determines on production, too, because here's another argument you can have. And I've worked at salary jobs and hourly jobs myself. I've worked in situations, too, we're getting away from the feminism, but we'll get right back to that, where you're both doing the same job. And why? And this is my thing. Why should that girl get paid more money when she's sitting on her can? Because I've been in positions like that where we both make the same amount of money, and yet I'm humping it. I'm working, making my money, and you got somebody else that comes in and just kind of like slides by.
That's what I go through.
And they still make the same amount of money.
And
so
whose fault is that?
I would have to say it's management. Again, it comes down to the management. It comes down to corporate. They don't want to fire people. They don't want to make decisions, and they don't really give a shit.
Okay, and then let's take that one step further. Immigration. Mm-hmm. It's not the immigrants' fault that are coming here for the jobs. It's the guys who's doing the hiring.
Right, absolutely.
That's people to blame. Right. Building the wall isn't going to be...
Yeah, but even your regular, your everyday people, all of us do it at the jobs. They hire people to do the menial jobs that nobody else will do, the housekeeping, the garbage, the lawn cutting. And at the same time, we all complain about it. I don't complain about it, but I'm just saying, you hear people complaining. But those are the same people that go, how much do you charge to clean my house?
Yeah.
oh, that's too much. Right. Or, you know, and these are the people that are, I don't know if they're the people complaining about it, but I'm just saying, again, we're playing both sides of it.
You're absolutely right.
You don't want them here, but yet you do want them here because you don't want to pay a lot of money for their service. So you can't play both. But, either keep them here or get them out. But then those people that don't want to work for $6 an hour or $3 for a cleaning job, whatever the ridiculous amount is, these people get paid. I don't see anybody, and I'm going to say this word, Caucasian whites, would ever do that kind of work for that kind of money. That's beneath them.
How many do you see out in the field picking lettuce or grapes?
None.
Zero.
Zero. So, again, we'll get back to the...
No, but it's the same issue. Yeah. It really is the same issue.
Yeah, but let's tie this into it too, right? Like, what would you say is, if somebody goes into business, what's their number one goal?
Make money.
To make money, right? Their number one goal is to make money. So one of the ways to do that is to pay your workers less, right? We don't want to overpay for workers.
No, that's a mistake, and I'll tell you why. Because if I pay my workers more,
right?
All right, they're going to have more money to spend.
True.
Going to spend it in our community. They're going to buy shoes for their kids. They're going to buy food. They're going to, and they're going to. The more money they make, the more disposable income they're going to have. The more people out there with disposable income are going to be good for my business.
Right, but most business owners don't think that.
But I'm thinking what Joe was trying to say before, John, was that a lot of the businesses, not all, for anybody that might get offended out there, not everybody operates this way. Their agenda in some cases is, let's pay the least amount and get the most amount of work.
So I can put it in my pocket.
Exactly. Right. So I think that was the point you were trying
to get. Let's take the business model, right? Now, you want to pay them enough to keep them there. The good workers. So let's look at it like this. If you're the type of business owner that's looking to pay your workers a good amount, but as little as possible that you can get away with. Well, if it's true that women get paid 70 cents on the dollar, why would we not fire every single male and hire all the women for 70 cents on the dollar? You would be making a 30% increase in your bottom line right off the top. The reason why it's not like that is because it's not true.
Yes, thank you.
Worker for worker, dollar for dollar, job for job, men and women do get paid equal. As a matter of fact, it even depends on the job that you're in. I used to be a model. I did Playgirl multiple times. You want to know how much money I got paid compared to your average, Playboy woman model? I got paid nothing compared to what they get paid. So it depends on what job you're in.
Because the market is smaller.
Exactly. And that's what runs it, too. Exactly. That's true.
Yeah.
So again, how do we get paid? Based upon the market. Right, if I'm selling widgets and nobody wants widgets, I'm not getting paid.
I think the other issue is,
you don't have to stay there.
Right, you have a choice.
That's true, too.
You can say, someplace else.
Again, it comes down, I was just going to say, the whole conversation, whether it's feminism, anti-feminism, who's making more money, who's not, it comes down to a decision. And it comes down to, whether you're going to take the victim mentality or not.
Right.
It doesn't matter what you're doing in life. You're either going to take the victim mentality and cry, like a lot of the feminists do, because they're lazy, or they just want what, I don't even know what they want, honestly. I can't even talk to a real feminist because they're kind of crazy.
Well, I'll tell you part of what they want, at least I think, and Ava, tell me if I'm right. They also want to govern how people think.
Yeah.
In other words, like one of the things I wrote down here is I saw a big deal about objectification, body shaming, things like this.
Oh my God.
It's like, okay, people are going to judge other people. Welcome to the real world. I don't care if you're a man or a woman, a dog or a cat. People look, they judge. They judge the car you drive. They judge the clothes you wear, what you say. It's not male, female. Right, so tell me what you think about that.
I think it's true. I think a lot of women get pissy when they're walking down the street in anything less than a thong, and then they want to complain and be like, oh, this guy keeps harassing me, this guy keeps catcalling me. Okay, well, guess what? What are you wearing? I'm not saying that that's okay. I'm not saying that, like, you should get harassed, but my thing is that if you see an attractive person walking on the street, whether they're in clothes or in literally nothing, you're going to look. I mean, when I see an attractive person, I'm going to be like, wow, you're very attractive. Does that mean that I want to sleep with you? No. Does that mean that if I call you beautiful, that means I'm trying to have sex with you? No, it doesn't. That just means I'm calling you beautiful. And I think that's what the women, they take that and they blow it out of proportion.
Hmm. Well, and the objectification too of women, that's the other thing you hear all the time too, is men are pigs, men are this. Well, women are the ones, I mean, I'm going to say it, they're the ones that dress a certain way and they act a certain way. And then when somebody says something, they get offended. Well, why are you offended? Because I already know that when you have that certain push-up bra in the gym, and I've had this discussion with him, that's done purposely. We all know that as women. There's workout bras and there's Victoria's Secret. Victoria's Secret you usually don't wear into this gym, okay? And then they're the first ones you'll hear in the locker room. Oh my God, did you hear what that guy just said to me? He totally scoped me out. Well, I'm scoping you out too, and I'm not a lesbian because your tits are in my face too, so don't get offended by it.
Isn't that
you
like
know?
The
I mean, and your ass is hanging out of those shorts, and I'm looking at your ass too, going, that's a pretty nice butt. But so you expect a man not to look and comment?
But isn't that like the Facebook girl who posts a picture and says, oh, by the way, next week is so-and-so day. Meanwhile, they're wearing no clothes. So it's really kind of like, I want you to see what I look like. You know, here's my new puppy. Meanwhile, they're not wearing any clothes practically. It's like they're trying to get attention by saying somebody's paying attention to me and they don't like it. When in actual fact...
Or when you see the girl on Facebook and they have like prerogative like photos, but then they want to put in the caption, no dirty comments. Like, seriously? Like, you're wearing a bra and panties, and yet you don't want anyone to say anything to you. It makes me so irritated. I'm like, and then they want to be like, and then girls, they do this thing where I'm being sexy for myself. Okay, well, just to let you know, when I want to be sexy for myself, I don't go outside wearing a mini skirt and a bra. I go out and I wear a nice pair of jeans, a nice t-shirt, and yes, I feel good on myself. I'm not saying that, you know, because I'm the less feminine type of woman, but that's just stupid. You could be sexy for yourself, but do it at your own house. Just like a guy. A guy can't walk down the freaking the road with
They have a couple guys that come in our gym and they wear the stretch pants. Well, you can see everything, outline of everything. Oh, and us girls are like, oh my God, like I don't want to look, but I'm looking. I'm not looking. And everybody gets so bent out of shape. And I said, but on the other side of it, I go, why is everybody getting so upset here? Do you know every day all I see is tits and ass in the gym? Everywhere I look, bend over a piece of equipment, nipples everywhere. And honestly, John, you got to join up. And honestly, a guy walks in with a pair of Speedos on or a tight pair of whatever they wear, and all the guys are going crazy. The girls are like, how dare he? Oh my God, we can see his whatever. Well, you know what? I could see your shit too. So what is your problem? So I think it's, but when you say something, and I think that's the problem.
What's the male version of a camel toe?
A moose toe.
A moose.
I knew that one.
Sorry. I just
heard it here first, folks. On Rise Above.
We heard it here on the Rise Above show.
Can't
get it, Rise
heard
Above.
I just think that women objectify themselves in a way because they don't. Like, they want to feel sexual, but then as soon as someone shows interest, then they want to reject it. But at the same time, if you think about it, men love it. And I'm not saying every man loves it. Like, if a guy has muscle and, you know, he's attractive, you know, 9 times out of 10, a woman's going to be like, "Whoo, hello, how you doing?" But at the same time, a man is okay with that for the most part. But the thing is that the I'm going to tell you the reason why men are okay with it is because they're not offended by everything. Women...
I don't have to say a word. That's women, absolutely true.
Like,
that's because, like, we are functional human beings.
I don't care if someone hits on me. If someone hits on me, I'll be like, thank you.
It's stupid to be offended. Yeah.
Like, if a girl's like, I love your abs, can I touch them? A guy's going to be like, yeah. But if a guy goes up to a girl and it's like, hey, can I touch your boobs? They're nice. A girl's going to be like, no, that's sexual harassment. Like, okay, I don't want no one touching my boobs, but it's just the point of, like, if someone says I'm attractive and is showing some type of sexual, like, interest, I'm going to be like, I still got it. I'm not going to care. But it's just, nowadays, women want to wear mini skirts, want to wear nothing, but then when someone shows interest in a sexual way, they want to go crazy. And it's like, okay, but just because someone is showing a sexual interest in you does not make them think less of a human of you. Like, they don't. Mm-hmm. Just because they think you're sexy or hot or attractive does not mean that they think you're nothing. Does not make you think that you, it doesn't make you think you're an object. You're still a human for the most part. People
but
think that way.
I also think it's worse than that, right? Though, because if you're a good-looking guy and you compliment a girl, they're going to be all about it, right? They're like, "Oh, thank you." But if you're kind of ugly and then you compliment the girl, all of a sudden it's like, hey, stay away. You know, there's this crazy guy after me. He's harassing me.
I know, I get that all the time.
And just for the record, not to bother you, but I mean, it's when you work out a lot, there are plenty of girls. It doesn't happen every day, but girls are always going, oh, can I touch? I mean, you're touching me already. You know, like, you're asking and doing it. And then if I pull back, everybody's like, what's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? Okay, can I do it? You know, they do that. I can't imagine. But I mean, think about, I can't even tell you how many times it's happened to me. And I'm not complaining. It's neither here nor there. I work out, so it's nice to be noticed. You know, it's like, I wonder about these women one day when they complain about being noticed, when they start to get a little older, when they start to become invisible. Now they're going to complain and be offended that nobody knows who they are, unless, of course, they were 23 years old. Right, they're gonna complain both ways.
Well, it's because it's like women want to be noticed, but at the same time, they want. It's like they want to be noticed, but then they don't. Like, they get noticed, and then they want to complain. It's like, okay, well, you don't have to dress prerogatively to get noticed. You can, you know, like, you can be a better person, have a good personality, have a good job, like, have ambition in life, and people can notice that about you. You don't have to use your looks. I don't use my looks. I mean, whatever. I think I'm pretty good looking, but I don't use that to my advantage. I use my achievements in life, and I try to push myself further. But it's like, people aren't attracted to, you know, people. It's like, and then women want to complain because then they're like, they see this good looking guy, and he could be like the biggest jerk in the world, but they don't care as long as he's hot. And that's the stupid. That's like the dumbest mentality you can have, because it's like, why would you? I would rather be with someone that's not the best looking but treats me like the world.
But you know what? We're wired as human beings that it's like the prettiest flower and the prettiest bug, animal, even in nature. We're wired even in the animal nature to the prettiest is what they go to, so we're already wired that
personally,
way.
Personally, I think hippos are pretty cute, so.
No, but I'm just saying, we're already attracted to things that we like, that we think are good looking, and everybody's version of what you think is good looking. I could see somebody and say, he's a really good looking guy, and you could look at him and say, no, he's not.
Yeah, I mean, it's all about preference. It's the same thing if a guy is like, I'm not attracted to women that are thicker, you know? I mean, everybody has a preference. Then he's a fat shamer. He doesn't want to be, he thinks that bigger women are ugly. It's like, no, he just doesn't want to have sex with you. Why is that a problem? He likes girl, and then there's guys out there that will like girls with big boobs. And oh my God, you don't like flat chesties. But then they're like, oh, well, I don't like a girl with big boobs. Oh my God, then you're gay. Like, there's just all these stupid things. And it's like, okay, but why can't you let people have a preference?
Yeah,
like,
it's just exactly dumb. Right. It's preferences.
It's dumb. Like, that would be the same aspect if I was like, I like women. Oh God, you're gay. Well, yeah, I'm gay. So that's correct. But that doesn't mean I hate men. I can look at a guy and be like, oh, he's attractive. Do I want to have sex with him? No. But I can say that he's attractive, just like his mom. She can go and she can be like, oh, that woman's attractive. Does she want to have sex with her? No. But it's just complimenting people, you know? It's just being nice.
So where does the word sexist come then in all this, honestly? I mean, we hear it all the time, you're right? It's like a guy looks at a girl, oh, that's sexist because we're objectifying. But when you really look at it, people who are people, we notice things that are beautiful to our eye. Like, why is it that there's a certain segment of our society that wants to say that it's an ugly thing to do for a man to look?
John.
I'll tell you what it is, what sexist is. It's a lack of respect.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
And if you're, let's say, oogling a woman or a man, right? And but
that's
there's
sexist.
No respect there. It's they.
I told him this one time. Not to interrupt you, I went into a tire place, and I tell this story to everybody. And I walked in. There's two young kids. They're in their 20s, and the kid said, "Sweetheart," to me. He goes, I see that he goes, can I help you, sweetheart? And I said, no, I'm going to go in there and see about my tires. And I went into the manager, and I told the manager, I said, you need to tell your young helpers out there how to speak to a woman, because I'm not his sweetheart, and that's disrespectful as far as I'm concerned. And he kind of looked at me and he said, there might be some people that wouldn't be disrespected by that, but me personally, they're in their 20s, I'm 50, and for them to call me sweetheart was demeaning to me. It wasn't a compliment.
Yeah.
So teach them that they address, either they figure out what my name is, or anything but sweetheart.
But if I were to say to you, oh my God, you are beautiful, and honestly mean that, I mean, is that offensive?
No.
Is that because...
I try to tell him that there's a difference between you got the creeper factor and you've got the disrespectful factor, and you can tell the difference.
Exactly.
You can tell.
And that was my point, and I think that most people can tell the difference in something like that, whether it's a respect thing or whether it's, you know, lecherous, I guess is the best word for that. And that goes
sexist.
Both ways, man, woman, women, you name it, whatever. That's the way I see it.
Hmm. I mean, if we really want to get down to it, men are actually more oppressed than women are, if you think about it.
Fucking A, Skippy.
I mean, if you think about it, because men really, they get more backlash for doing or not doing certain things than women do. Women can dress in freaking, in guys' clothing, or, well, non-gender conforming, I don't really care, but they can dress in jeans and a t-shirt and nobody says anything. But if a guy wants to wear a dress, oh God, he's a fag. he's gay.
You know,
he's all, like, it doesn't, it's just stupid.
You need to be really proud right now. You have
I raised her. You, they said the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
You see how she ditches me? And okay. She doesn't want to hear something nice. Now that everybody sees that, this is so what happens all the time. All
right, say something nice.
You have done an amazing job raising your daughter. It's taken me 50 years to try to learn how to speak publicly, and I'm still not good at it. And Ava is incredible.
Ava's
like,
Ava.
Right? Yeah. I mean, that's. Yeah.
I can't. When people say, you're just like your mom, I always say, no, she's got her own thing going. I mean, she's my daughter, but I don't want. You know, when people say you're like me or you look like me or this and that, it's like, no, she's herself.
Yeah.
You know.
Let me ask Ava a question, because she kind of brought it up. Men being oppressed, or is it possible that the sexism works both ways? Here's an example. Just a thought. And I'll let you answer the question for me. It doesn't matter what I think. I'll let you think for me. I'm a therapist now also. It's about 80% female business. I go in for my first major job interview. I sit down. I'm nervous. And I told her at the end, I said, well, how did I do? I haven't had a real interview in 30 years. And she said, oh, don't worry about it. You had the job before you came in. I was like, well, why would that? She said, because you're a man. And I went, that was my resume? She said, yeah, we need some testosterone around here. I was like,
yeah, like that's going to help.
Thank you. So I went on another job interview. Same thing. She goes, yeah, it would be nice to have some testosterone around here.
But could you imagine if a man said
finish?
That?
Yeah, I know, but let me, because it's one more time, it's even better. Third interview, same thing. She comes. She calls me in for the second interview, and she says, you know, we like, you know, the interview was good, but we just don't know if we want your kind of testosterone.
Like what?
You're a little on.
You're a little on the big side.
You're a little on the more masculine side, and we don't know with our adolescents that you would be the role model because you might make them a little nervous. I'm like, really? Okay, so let's reverse that. Woman comes in, and I go, you got the job. You got a vagina. Yes. Like, am I into, like,
so, nice, no, yes. So you
it's estrogen.
Okay, I moved it a little.
You have the right kind of estrogen we're looking for.
You have just the right amount of estrogen. Imagine? I like the estrogen.
I like your estrogen.
Estrogen.
Yeah.
You know, the estrogen thing. Like, so go ahead. You tell me, like, should I be offended? Was that sexist towards me?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, I mean, is it not? Like, and it's that way almost all the time in therapy now.
But that's the thing the problem is that the first thing that she looked on was your looks, but she didn't even really get a chance to, like, understand your personality because you're very, like, you're a very soft, gentle person, but just because you work out, that automatically means you're like the Hulk, and that's not true. Because no. The thing is,
you know,
I'm
so
like,
glad you said that.
I had that first thought when I met Joe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I really did.
Yeah.
You were being sexist. Yep.
I absolutely was.
I thought, that's the thing. Like,
okay, here's another muscle-bound jerk.
Well, yeah, like,
until I heard their first show.
Yeah, like, when I see a guy that's on the
Yeah, but you
show,
were
like, oh,
you were
scared,
up enough
but.
To say it, too. You did say it. You did, you know, like, yeah. You did say, I misjudged you, guys. I really, most people won't say that they made a little misjudgment.
Right, and that's the other thing.
You don't
want to
somebody.
Admit,
don't
want to
admit it.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's the thing, like, with that, like, yeah, because, I mean, I look like Flubber, and yet people are like, oh, she must be really nice. No. I mean, I'm nice.
I never got that impression.
Well, no, it's because I put it out there. But the thing is, like, at work, like, I'm like the nicest person. Like, people wouldn't even think. And my friend Nicole was at work, and she's like, you are so nice. I'm like, you should see me when I'm not here, because people don't like me, because I say things that come off my head, and people are like, what? But that's the thing. Like, people are gonna judge. They look at you, and they're gonna be like, oh, be like, well, you know. Like, when I first met Joe, I was kind of like, I was, like, kind of scared. I was like, oh, God, he's so buff. He's going to, like, strangle me. But as I got to know him, I was like, you know what? He's really cool. And as long as, like, my mom happy, I could care less. I like him. He's cool. But the thing is, like, I feel like everybody judges everybody at first. It's a part of life. Right. You're going to. Like, if you see somebody, you're going to be like, oh, you know, that's just a part of human nature. But it's the point of, like, not just subjecting to the judgment and actually trying to, like, get to know the person. Hmm. Not just be like, oh, you are buff, so you're automatically a jerk. You have a beard, so you're nasty. Or just, like, whatever, like, the case is, like, I'm just saying, like, whatever judgment you have, like, to get to know the person as a personality, not just as their looks, because, you know, it's just, I don't know, that's just my opinion. But, yeah, I agree. I think that's sexism, but I think that as soon as a man shows any type of, like, sensitivity or emotion, they're weak, they're a pussy, and I don't like that. That really makes you mad, because one of my best friends, he's straight, and he's married to a woman. He's completely straight, like, he has no, but he loves to cross-dress. He loves wearing feminine clothing. If he was walking down the street, you would literally think it was, like, two lesbians. But he gets so much crap for that. And he's very sensitive, but he's not transgender. He's just really, like, sweet, and it just pisses me off because people just, they call him more so lots of names. But if a girl did the same thing and they were wearing, like, a suit, you don't really get that much backlash. I haven't. Like, if I wear a suit, people are like, you look good. But if a guy wears a dress, they're like, oh. And it's just that, I feel like guys are more oppressed in that way when it comes to that.
Yeah, I would agree. It's hard to be a guy and say that, because nobody's going to be on your side.
Yeah.
You know, just to make this conversation a little bit weirder, because I was looking at some other stuff to think about.
A little more weird.
Yeah, only because I was thinking about this a lot, and I've had this conversation with a couple of girls and some men throughout my years, and it's really interesting. If you look at, I know this is going to be a gross word, right? But let's talk about genital mutilation for a second. Right, like this whole, I was looking up this feminism thing, and that's one of the things on their list. It's like, we have to end that around the world and blah, blah, blah. It's a terrible thing. And it is, no doubt. But we do genital mutilation on boys in this country all the time, and no one says a word. Like, you can, if you say something about, you know, about circumcision, everybody's like, it's just the way it's supposed to be. No, you're not supposed to be carving off a boy's penis. Like, it's make it his decision if it's that important when he gets older. And I bet you this, he's not going to want to.
Well, they say not to, and I totally agree with what
so
you're saying.
So it's torture. We torture boys.
But they're
saying
when they're oppressing, they're opposed to the female mutilation. The reason they are is because when you cut off a woman's clitoris, she has no sexual feeling at all down there. A man, and I'm not saying I agree with it, I'm not saying any of it. I'm saying a a man still has, he can still have an orgasm, he can still have sensation on his penis, even though he's been circumcised. So the argument with cutting off a woman, a little girl's clitoris, is the fact that she cannot enjoy sex.
No, I agree.
Sex isn't needed, though. That's the thing.
No way am I saying that's not good.
Yeah.
No. I guess I'm not going to say anything to that one because I can't agree with that one. I'm sorry. Sorry.
The only thing the clitoris is for is for pleasure, and that is awesome, and I love it, and it's great. It's, you know, but what I'm talking about is that when we talk about male circumcision, everybody just goes, whatever, it's a boy, cut it. And it's like, hold it. They are doing so much work now with MRIs to figure out that you, before 4 years old, you feel pain and you remember it, and that garbage gets downloaded into your brain, and you're torturing the boy. Typically they do it, what, for 2 weeks after he's born? They're doing this. A lot of times they do it without anesthesia. It's an amazing thing that people just go, not a big deal.
They do, because it's what they've been culturally been conditioned to say is okay, and it's a religious thing 90% of the time.
But it also began as a health issue.
Right. So while these therapists and all these medical people are finding this out, then maybe they need to get out in the community and do the crusades like other people would do and say, we can't do this anymore to the young boys, and this is why, and get it to stop. Go to the churches, go to the places that, you know, they're still doing this, and re-educate them, because that's an old world, old, you know, belief system that they're still doing even today. So people don't think there's anything wrong with it, you know?
But if you're a feminist and you want rights, and you have rights, I think you should care about all people. That's my thing. Mm-hmm. It's human rights. And if you have female circumcision, and we know that that's wrong, and it's abusive, and it's torturous, you should be able to look into it and say, okay, it's not right for boys either.
Well, you know, I think true feminists, though, they don't like men. So I think...
Well, that's the point that I'm getting at.
You're not going to have that happen. You'd have to have more of the anti-feminism women.
You need to change... The thing is, the problem is you got to change the name of feminism. Yeah. Because the thing is, you have to call it, like, something with the word equal in it. Because you think of feminism and you think of just, it's all about women. And the sick part about circumcision is, yes, there's a small health issue when it comes to it, because I've looked up to it, and yes, it can...
You have looked into that,
too. It has a little bit of a beginning of an infection because of the area, but for the most part, it's sick that your parents would do it strictly for appearance. That's all it's for. Mm-hmm. It's strictly for appearance. Why are you trying to make your son already sexualized when he gets older? He should make that... I mean, yes, women look at a guy that's not circumcised and be like... I mean, it does kind of look weird, but some girls don't care, and the thing is, you have to make your son decide when he gets to a certain age, do you want this or do you not? You don't do it when they're a baby, and then it's strictly just for appearance. That's all it's for. It has nothing to do with, like...
But it comes down to education. Yeah. You know, it comes down to getting rid of some of the old beliefs that, you know, people have, and the smarter we're supposed to be getting as a world, that then you need to change some things that have been going on for a million years, and we're not. We're moving forward in a lot of ways. Technologically, we are, but when it comes to other things, sit in the background. But there needs to be more proactive people.
Yeah, no, I agree. Go out there and but say, if we're going to talk about this. Yeah, if we're going to talk about feminism, right, and they want equal rights, they should want to make things all equal. When you have empathy and compassion for human beings, it should be that way. If you only have empathy and compassion for your gender, I think by definition that means you don't have empathy and compassion for people. Yeah. It means what's the difference of that between saying I only like blonde blue eyes and I'm going to be a Nazi? It's not that much different when you really think of it.
But I think that's where the anti-feminists came into this whole thing. They kind of cut away from the feminist saying, because like myself, I don't want to be called a feminist. Because I work and I make money,
we're
and
not
I'm missing it. I don't want. So we say we're anti-feminist, and somebody goes, well, "What's that supposed to mean?" I go, "It means that I believe in equal rights for everybody." And this crap about male bashing, and we don't need men to have our babies. Yes, you do. I don't care what you want. The baby needs a male in their life. Period. Mm. So these are women that have had either bad experiences with men, they're bitter, so they don't like men, or they're lesbians that don't like you know, they're not into men. I'm just saying, I've run into women like that that are lesbians, and all men are terrible.
I get it.
They hate men. So I would have to say a majority of the feminists are women that are lesbian.
But okay? In order to hate men, they have to hate themselves first. Right, the hate is in here, and then they can't take it, so they say it. The problem's here; they project,
or they've had a bad experience, and they project. Either way, it's their belief, it's their projection of what they think.
Mm.
So, I think it should be what you say, what you just said, equality.
Absolutely,
it's just equal. Mm. But then, like I said, there's a tender side of the equality. Then, where's the respect? We can't compromise the respect part of it. Where, if all of a sudden we say everybody's equal, women and men, does that mean that, you know, we totally disregard respecting each other? Like, I don't want to be around a bunch of guys talking crap. I don't know what men talk about.
I think the equality thing, I mean, inherently means respecting each other.
Right. No,
truly. And anybody who feels the other way, that, okay, you want equality, so now it's okay for me to talk any way I want in front of you. That's bullshit.
Right.
That's a lack of respect, whether male, female, doesn't make any difference. It's a lack of respect for you as a human being. Not as a woman, not as a man, not as anything else.
As a human.
I think people separate equality and respect, though, to an extent, because, I mean, there can't really be equality without respect, but at the same time, people can be like, oh yeah, there's equality, but it doesn't mean I have to respect you, in a sense. Like people have this mentality of, like, yes, we can have equality, but you're still a bitch. Yeah, like, we can have equality.
Yeah, if you don't have to like everybody.
Basically, what people are saying is, like, oh, well, if a man has sex with all these women, he's praised, but that's the oldest thing in the book.
Yep.
But if a woman has sex with all these men, she's a whore. Yes, I do believe that they should both be called a whore, because if you're going to have sex with everybody and you don't have protection, yes, you're a freaking whore. That's just, it's simple. But I think that should be...
Like, I love that you're saying that, too. Because in actuality, what we're talking about here is just judgment.
Yeah.
Right? Now, if you have a guy that sleeps with, let's say, Will Chamberlain, right? He wrote a book saying that he slept with 20,000 women. Trust me, he's being judged. Right? I mean, great basketball player, but a horrible human being. I think we would all say that in terms of how he treats women. Or if he would be good to have a life with, and, you know, and have a relationship with. But we get judged. Let's look at the guy who doesn't, say, have a lot of opportunities and doesn't sleep with any women, really. Do we judge him? Of course we do. You know, we say he's kind of a loser. And if a woman sleeps with a lot of guys, well, I don't know. Maybe in high school they might judge you, because there's other guys that go, well, maybe I could have a chance too. That's true. I get it. But that's a judgment. I don't know if it's sexist. I think it's opportunist, you know. And, you know, as women get older, who's chasing you down? I'd like to know. Like, is anybody asking you or chasing you down going, hey, how many times did you have sex this week? Like, does anybody really care that much?
Well, no, because I know, when I talk to people, I feel like there's, like, a number with everybody. Like, there's a number of people you can actually have sex with, and then it's too much. Like, honestly, like, I feel like it's too much with both sides. Like, if I see a guy and he's had sex with, like, 100 people, I'm going to have an issue. If a girl has sex with 100 people, we're going to have an issue. It's just that simple.
And you wouldn't tell anybody anyway.
The only person I care about who I'm having sex with is who I'm having sex with.
Absolutely.
Because I need to know who you've had sex with so you don't have anything to give me. But other than that, I don't care. You've had sex with everybody in the world.
Give me your blood test.
We're running out of time. Do you have a message you want to leave? 30 seconds. You got 30 seconds. 20, actually.
I don't know. I think we just need to, like, learn how to, like, respect each other and love each other more and stop stereotyping literally everything we do and let everyone just be who they are.
Do you have any last minute words?
No, I just love the show. I like listening to Ava. That was great.
Well,
I like her point of view, too. I agree with it.
Well, everybody, we hope you have a good weekend. It's Palm Sunday this Sunday. So go get your palms at church and have a good, and your ashes on your forehead on Ash Wednesday. That's Wednesday. So
thanks for watching the Rise Above show.
Thank you.